Hello, and welcome to my little corner of the woods. This is Fennel Fox Art, and today we're going to be working on our Sentinel of the Corner. He's a little squirrel. He's a wonderful little vanguard, taking care of everything, protecting the woods from all of the evil cars and whatnot that would run over his acorns. And today we're going to be adding shading to his little squirrely tail. Giving him some fur. We're just going to jump right on ahead into it today. So I've got a lair going for him already. Gonna get real close. Right? Hello, Talonix. Welcome in. Glad to see you here. Glad to hear you from downstairs. All right. Gonna get right in and we're gonna start on his little leg here. Just gets to shading. We're gonna cel shade this little guy. He's a little more cartoony. Get his really round little leg here. Just kind of rough that in. Move on to the other one. Just round off his little knees. These fuzzy little knees. Go a little bit further than what we actually need, and we can come back in and erase it off later. As always, you know, the usual way. It's mostly top-down lit. I've decided on this little guy. Belly. Pressure sensitivity on, and then we can give him some little fur lines into the shading here. Right. Make that look a little more intentional on the side here. I think it's a little too haphazard. And that looks pretty good. Move on over to this side. and get that there. Get the extra off his boots. So when you're a soldier, you gotta keep your boots clean. It's important, you know? All right. So that little bit of shading there. We'll get some in for his arm. And his little belt there. And a tiny bit on this side for the staff. Okay. Move up to his arms. Hey, Dead Red Skittle, welcome in. Always glad to see you in my stream. Drawner, squirrely little sentinel today. Getting some more shading work in. Down the arm here, around his elbow, and across for the pauldron. I think that's what that's called. I could be wrong, but I believe so. Shoulder pauldron sounds right. I don't know much about armor, but I do draw an awful lot of it. Better before. Get that there. That off. There we go. Thin that out. Move up to his little neck here. Big ol' head causing a big shadow here. there's all of that. Shadow for the staff. Shadow for these pauldrons. Much thicker on this side. And this is the side that'll have that sort of shadow. In there. Right. There we are. Okay. And there is all of that. Kind of nicely shadowed in there. Add a little bit more around this hand here. How's that looking? Looking pretty good, I think. Maybe a little bit thicker on this shoulder strap shadow here. Just a little bit. Yeah, that's good. Right. And up to his little face. Hey there, Drasonic. How's it going today? Glad to see you in. His little ears. nice smooth in here. Oh, come on, guys. Let's keep it kind in the chat here today. Don't want to be shading anybody. Nobody's late. Everybody is simply early for next week's stream. Including me, because I'm always late to my own stream. So that's no big deal at all. I'm just happy anybody's showing up at all. Get his chubby little cheeks shaded in here. I'm gonna get this shape defined with this shadow on his face. Right. Soften that out. Right. Get the same sort of thing on the other side here. Kind of really enhancing how much you can tell he's got them chubby, chubby cheeks. Beautiful. All right. There's all of that gray shading there. I'm gonna get that darkness right in his tail here, I think. Just get that preliminary. Hello, Kaluma. Welcome in. It's nice to see you here. You are right. We give him the absolute chubbiest of possible cheeks. Get them as chubby as humanly possible. Or as squirrely possible, I suppose. All right. Give him just some real, real basic donutty kind of shading over here. Donutty? Rounded is what I meant to say, but donutty is what came out. I guess donutty. Hashtag donut squirrel. I mean, no, that's an idea for a drawing. Fucking donut squirrel. Yeah, there we go. He's starting to come together now. Aw, thank you so much, Kayluma. That is one of the nicer things that has ever been said to me. Bob Ross vibes. Killing me with kindness. Especially with the squirrel, because he always had his pet squirrels. Well, his rescue squirrels, but still. I do what I can. Make this stream a relaxing, kind place. Even if we are cultivating the dankest of memes. Our beautiful friend here. All right, so there is our gray shading layer. Go ahead and get another one on here. And we're gonna go in with the dark gold. Chunky little boots. Soldier is nothing without his boots. It's the most important part. His own chonk overhanging here, causing this shadow. Give that an erase. That and erase. Just a little boop. Alright. And then the same on the other side. Taper that down. And there we are. Little boots. Get the detailing on his straps here, the shading here. Try and match up that arm shading with the shading on his fur underneath it. Yes, there we go. And then a little bit at the back. Coming up out of here, get that for the staff. cauldrons. Head. Forearm. And erasing. Of that shading. And we can actually do the helmet on the same layer because none of that touches each other. And so that makes my life a little easier. I'll go ahead and get this light gold in here. And looking at how long we've been going, I think we might actually get to start a new project today, which will be exciting. I'm planning on streaming for a little bit longer today than I normally do. That's the goal, anyhow. We shall see how that goes. Go in here. Let's go ahead and get a darker gold. Come in. And shading metal is different than shading pretty much anything else in most types of drawing. But in this case, it's all kind of the same. It all just sort of looks the same way. It's really the highlights that are gonna look completely different, because I do a sort of hybrid shading and highlighting system where everything isn't completely cell shaded or completely blending shaded, I guess you would call it. I don't really know the term for that one. It's all sort of both. I just think it looks nice. It's interesting. Come in here and round this up. That. Okay. A little bit on this side for his ear protruding around it. Just the tiniest little bit. And then we're going to make our brush much smaller. We're going to go ahead and outline around all of these little holes here. Actually, on the other side of where I've done that. Here. So that is where it would be shadowed. This particular case. All right. We're going to get even darker here. We're going to go into those. Lower the opacity a bit. can really get in there and define these up. Just sort of loosely. I'll sort of define that a little bit more cleanly later with a highlight. And that just gives it more sort of obvious look on that detail. Yeah, I like that. Give that a blend, give all of these a blend, and that looks good. All right. Okay. Now reselect this darker gold color and hop up onto a new layer to do the pauldrons. Turn my opacity back up here. These are pretty easy to do. It's relatively straight lines on everything. One side. Actually, it'd be easier if I turn the pressure sensitivity off for that. There we go. Better. Okay, and now for the spear. Which I haven't totally decided what the material for this is. Oh, thank you, Drasonic. I haven't decided if it's a lighter gold or if this is a wood. Which I think is kind of an important thing to pick before you shade the whole thing in. I know that the blade up here is definitely a gold though, so I can go ahead and shade that. I'm gonna do that on the same layer actually. pretty much it done, actually. I'm thinking wood. I do already have a shading color for this, though. Give it the tiniest shadow. Just smooth that on out. There we are. You've got the shadow of his hand, his fuzzy little paw. Get that furry little digits. There's that. And continuing the shadow. Drawing in a straight line. So hard. To get off some of the excess from that. Smooth it out. And beautiful. Right. Moving back up to the acorn, just to give it the tiniest little touch of dimension on the side here.
And there we are. All right, there is all of the basic cell shading done on this guy. I think he's looking pretty good so far. Now I think it's time to get some dimension in this little guy. How do I want to do this? Thank you, Kaluma. I very much appreciate it. I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to take a browner tone, but not too much darker. Go quite low on the opacity. And work my way through his fur. And see what I can get it to do. Oh yeah, that's looking cool. That way we can get some dimension in here without going too crazy. There we go. That's adding just a little bit at a time. I dare say. I think I've found a new favorite way of doing fur. Gotta do his belly, forgot about that. Can't forget about the belly. There we go. Okay. That has fixed that problem. Now he's got belly shading. Yeah. Yeah, that's much better. We love the belly shading. Right. Heading on back in. Get some of this darker gray. Add a little brown. Add a little darker. Add much less opacity. And go in. Some longer strokes on this. Don't want to go too overboard on it. Right. And I think the next thing I'm going to do is go with a highlight for this. So I'm going to grab his base gray color and go lighter and grayer. And head to the outer edges and just kind of pop some of that on. in shorter strokes towards the outside. There we go. Because squirrels kind of have all that floof on their second layer of fur. Adding more dimension in that, go even lighter and a little smaller. Right, that's a good start on that there. We'll go all the way up. I think this is probably the lightest I'm gonna do on the tail here. We'll go all the way down with the hardness, make it really float. And just go right to the edges. Get up in close. Add this in. Get out here and blend in that tail. Make him look real fluffy-like. Gotta make him look real fluffy-like. Fluffy is the best way for a squirrel to look. You gotta make him look real fluffy. There we go, there's his tail. Now we just gotta get in here and get his armor all highlighted. And it's as simple as that. And then give it a blend. And there's a good, easy highlight. You can put a little more oomph into it if you keep working it, but basically, it's all you gotta do. Helmet. He is fluffy. He is a very fluffy boy. Look at him, this little shiny boy. Isn't he precious? Isn't he beautiful? All right. Now we gotta go above the lines here. We gotta get some real serious highlights. Some real thin ones. in here and erase these off of everywhere they're not supposed to be. Which currently is anywhere but the tail. Add one to the nose. Add a little bit to eye. Add a little highlight to boot, why not? Just lock these into the tail here. Right. We're gonna have to go into this group here. Merge this group and erase all of it off of the staff. Check around the edges, see if anything is overhanging too much. It's not too bad. Not too bad. We definitely need some out of the ears here. The thing about squirrels is they have big ol' real floofy ears. We can't go without the floofy ears if everything else is floofy. And the beautiful, floofy-eared boy. He is complete. Say hello to the Sentinel of the Forest. Welcome to our lovely boy. Welcome to life. You are beautiful, just the way you are, in all of your chonky glory. All right. So now with him done, if everybody is up for it, I'd love to get a vote from the chat. I'm down to keep going, and I've got something else to be working on. So if you guys are still wanting to hang out, then we can keep going here. So I'm just going to switch over to my logo while I do some stuff in the background and open that up. So just let me know. And while I'm doing this, if you guys have any ideas for names for our darling Sentinel of the Forest, why don't you go ahead and leave those in the chat and we can look through them together. I don't actually have a name for him. He doesn't have a name. He has pauldrons and a precious little fluffy tail, but no name. All right. So what we've got going on here, dear friends, is something very exciting indeed. We have ourselves a snailer. And how many viewers have I lost with that pun? Let's see it. Oh, he's a snail sailor. I came up with this one night, middle of the night. He's a thing of beauty, if you ask me, but I may be the only one who shares this opinion. He's got his little striped shirt and his little sailor's hat, just hanging out. So we're gonna go ahead and get started on his line work today, and we're gonna stream forever. Super stream. Let's see, what's that looking like? That's far too big. Beautiful. Thick line boy. Yeah, Drasonic. Oh, nope, that was dead red. Sorry about that. There we go. Gotta turn on this smoothing. For sure. Get these eye stalks. That's a good one. Nah. I like that one. Ooh, yes. Get that curvy boy in there. Beautiful, beautiful. Right. Get the neckline of his shirt. Get that on in there. There we go. Beautiful. Now this shell is going to be a little tricksy. I'm going to turn this smoothing way up. We're going to see how far we can get here. I'm actually going to draw this on a different layer, I think. Ugh. You know, I don't hate that, so I think we're gonna go with it. Right. Does, however, mean we're gonna have to change this line here, which is fine, we can do that. Just means he's gonna be a long boy. There we go. That's not bad at all. A little smile. And draw on his little sailor hat. Turn the smoothing off mostly. That's a good one. Nice. Nice. Scoot that hat up. Deselect it there. can go about, head back in here and erase that bit. And I think there is our snaily boy. With his snaily hat and his snaily eyes. This one's a bit of a quick draw for his lines. So why we're able to do a little bit of a double stream today. Merge this down. Got our little buddy. And we can go ahead and get started on our colors, actually. Now, I don't know what colors you guys all think of when you think of snails, but I think of like a grayish, bluish sort of tone. And that's not what an actual snail looks like, even slightly. Not even a little bit. But it's what this snail is gonna look like, because he's a cartoon. So that's how we're doing it today. This is what we're doing, I suppose. My snail, my rules. Yeah, that's a good color. Don't really draw a lot of blue things most of the time, but then I draw ocean things and it always ends up blue. So much blue in the ocean. So it only makes sense that this snailer would end up blue. He's a fun little guy. I think his name is Pierre. Pierre the Snailer. He is fresh. Don't ask me what that was. I mean, obviously it was an atrocious attempt at a terrible French accent, but it is in our past. There is that, and I think this color, yes, that for the snail's shell. Beautiful. Makes him look a little more green, but I do like it. Get this shell in. You're a shell-in, Pierre. A shell-in for cutest pun I've ever drawn. I love snails. Snails are so misunderstood. People are like, ew, snails. But snails are precious little baby darlings with terrifying, terrifying amounts of teeth. And snails hibernate, which is a fact that I found out somewhat recently, actually. Which is fascinating to me. Why do snails hibernate? Who knows? Not I, friends. Not I. Oh my god, Drasonic. Have I ever gotten snail mail before? I'm not even gonna dignify that with a response. I don't even... You know, I make bad puns, but that's just pain, my friend. That was rough, buddy. That was my girlfriend turned into the moon levels of rough, buddy. Right. Oop. A little too far on that. And then we go in and we gotta get a good red. I want more of a scarlet color. That's gonna be lovely. Yes. Get a new layer and get those stripes on his shirt. Beautiful. The blue and this sort of scarlety red together is one of my favorite color combinations in the world. This sort of pastel-y, powdery blue and this sort of darker red. I love it together. It's gorgeous. You're gorgeous, Pierre. Gorgeous. While we're up here, let's get a little anchor on your hat.
cute.
Maybe a little red rim. Yeah, that looks good.
All right, Drasonic, I see you trying to be Azula in the chat. Gonna come in here with a little bit of pencil. And outline this anchor. Maybe use the charcoal. That pencil's not looking quite how I want it to. Yeah, that's better. Much more the vibe I'm going for. Yeah, that's better. No worries, Drasonic. No worries about your terrible typing. I am also quite bad at typing. Let's get this white back in here. Pop some eyeballs on our little snail buddy. Great.
What a little friend. Pierre, our little friend. I want to put some waves on his shell. Let's get some waves on him. There we go. Get a very soft brush. And a selection tool. Sample all the layers. Select down here. Gonna go opacity very, very low. Start at the top. Work our way down. Make the brush bigger, it'd be helpful. And when you deselect, you've got a cool pattern. Yeah, I think that looks pretty chill. All right, keep darkening that wave until it looks right. And deselect. I think probably I'm not gonna shade this shell. I'm just gonna leave it with this pattern and shade the rest of him. I think that'll look fine. That way I won't have to mess about with getting all of this shading correct over top of this gradient here. Shading with this kind of gradient would be a sort of nightmare, honestly. Section there. Just darken that up. This one here. That one doesn't get all the way because the hat is on top of where it would be the darkest. Select all of the rest of these at once, I think, and I'll be able to do them easily enough. There we are. This is a lovely shell pattern. Hey, Fennel Fox Art, looking great. Are you using an art pad? If so, which kind do you prefer? Thank you so much. Welcome N. If by art pad you mean a drawing tablet, then the answer is yes. I currently am using a Huion? I'm totally unsure how to pronounce that. Don't know, to be perfectly honest with you, how that's pronounced, but it's the one that I'm currently using. My old one was a Wacom. Those are both great. Huion is vastly, vastly less expensive. And honestly, I kind of prefer the tablet that I'm working on right now, which is the Huion. So I would recommend that one, currently, over the Wacom, just because it is about the same quality of tablet, but the price is so much more manageable. Like, the one I'm working on right now, I don't remember what it is called, but it is, I think it was $85. And my Wacom that you can't even get anymore at the time was around $200. And now the cheapest one that I could find that was comparable was, I think, $400. So the Huion is definitely, definitely much more worth it. And personally, I prefer the ones without screens. I just don't like the way that that feels, drawing on one with a screen. To each their own, of course, but that is my own opinion. I know everybody's always super into the Cintiqs and everything, but I'm not really about that so much. Right. I think I'm going to go ahead and get started on his shading here. We've got all of the basic color on our snailer. Pierre. Go ahead and get this green in here. Darken that up. And get going. Right. Zoom right on into his little face. His little smile. Make that a little darker, actually, I think. Just a little bit. Get his own eyes shadowed in here. Blend that in a little bit. going to have slightly more blendy shadows than our sentinel friend. I'm going to go ahead and pop on over. And get all of this shadowed in here. Certainly. The hand-eye coordination is definitely something to get used to. But I think as long as you are prepared to work on that, it's very much worth the investment to give it a shot. And pretty much everyone can do it. It's really not a difficult thing to work for. The program is definitely something you've got to think about as well. I personally don't really like anything except Photoshop, but I know that I am very much in the minority there. A lot of people use Krita or Paint Tool Sai, and they're perfectly happy with them. Or even you can use GIMP if you really need to, and that one is free. And just so you're looking up the right thing, I'm going to go ahead and spell that in the chat for you, just because my pronunciation is absolutely atrocious. Paint.net. I don't know if I've heard of that one. That's interesting. And Blender, yep, definitely. Photoshop can be a little bit intimidating. There's a lot going on, and it is kind of expensive, for sure, because you can't buy the program. It has to be a subscription per month, which is definitely irritating, but it is what I learned on, and it's just my favorite thing to use to date. Right. You've got that in there. Yes, the outline is on its own layer. I've got this layer here that is on its lines. If I turn that off, you can see where all of my painting is. Ooh, that looks gross. his little eyes just kind of floating in the air there. I should actually name that layer. Should name that lines. So thank you for reminding me that. Yeah, that's just something I like to do to contain all of the painting in one area, especially when I'm doing something that's a little more cartoony. You really got to keep track of all of your layers and make sure that you don't lose track of where things are, because otherwise you're going to end up painting on the wrong layer and cover over things you don't want to be. It's not too difficult, especially with a program like Photoshop, because you can just rename anything at any time. Like group 2, I'm going to name shading. And group 1 is color base.
which is just a basic way that I keep track of how everything is going. And you can see I've got a black layer and a white layer and a 50% gray layer. And that's just to check that all of my values are sort of within the right range, so that I'm not like drawing something far too light or far too dark. And it's much easier to do that with digital art than any sort of physical art. Although I am an oil painter, primarily, I learned a lot of digital art when I went to school. Right, now I'm gonna go ahead and get his shirt shaded here. I'm actually just going to select all of these white stripes. And that's going to make my life easier. Turn the tolerance up a little bit. Oh, Frev, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to the Forest Gang. I have just now decided that I am going to call my people that, the Forest Gang. Got a bit of a forest theme here. Drawing primarily animals, and they're all kind of part of a connected world that I've got going on. So thank you so much for joining us. Great. Go ahead and get this in here. For sure needs to be darker, but I can fix that with a brightness and contrast layer. Perfect. Another thing that a lot of people are afraid of when they're working in Photoshop is they're so scared of using adjustment layers while they're working, but it's really just another tool at your disposal. Oh, you're from the Church of Chill. Oh, that's wonderful. I'm so glad. Yes, actually, I do have So he announced that it was to make a gift for somebody, and I have something absolutely perfect. I don't know if you know of Banjo and Blush, but I was actually already working on drawing a portrait of him. And so I'm going to go ahead and submit that for the Gauntlet piece this week. And I'm very excited about it. His Banjo is a great streamer. And he pops in here sometimes, but he misses my stream a lot because we have super different schedules. Like, completely different. I stream in the daytime and he streams at like 4 a.m. half the time. Which is madness. I could never do that. Not because I'm not up, mind you, but because I don't have that kind of energy. Yeah, I love drawing portraits of people. I have them send me reference pictures and we get some really beautiful, if I do say so myself, portraits out of it. And it's really fun to just study people's features and see what you can do. It helps a lot with shading your own artwork as well, which you wouldn't necessarily think, but you just kind of learn anatomy through staring at people's faces for hours on end, which is just sort of how they did it before they knew what anatomy was like from the inside out, is they just sort of stared at people and figured things out. Piece of leg to that. Beautiful. Give that a quick blend. Move on up to the hat. Yes. I was a little worried about that too, actually, last week, how dark we can get with the, poetry. I was like, this is a little serious. I don't know how much this is gonna work out in Billy's stream. He's got a whole chill vibe kind of a deal going on. I don't know if I want to bring people down like that. But it worked out, and people seemed to like it. I do love poetry, and I don't get a whole lot of chances to experience other people's poetry. So I'm very excited that this Gauntlet thing is kind of going in that direction. There was so much poetry last time, too. Quick blend. Wrong layer. You see, I do it all the time. Gotta keep track. There we go. There we are. Alright, and all that we have left is our highlighting. Just that little bit of shine. On our golden boy snailer. Come in real close and get that good highlight right in. And here we have our shiny little snailer. He is Finny. Just gotta drag in our logo. Et voila. Thank you. I am quite proud of him. And I think that just about concludes our double stream here today. So, just to recap, we have our lovely Pierre, our Snailer, and the other one that we've finished today was our Sentinel of the Corner. Thank you so much, Kaluma. I still don't have a name for this guy. Do we have any suggestions in the chat? He's our fluffy little boy. Just a Vanguard squirrel without a name. Nut. The once and forever king, his name shall be Nut. Thank you, Kaluma. Thank you. And that is our stream. Thank you all so very much for watching. Merry meet, merry part, and merry meet again. I hope you all have a very fantastic day. Goodbye.